Hi everyone, welcome you all. My name is Pavan. So in this video I'm going to show you how to use the tuples in Python. Now let's get started. So tuples are very similar to the list type in Python, but once a tuple is created, you cannot add, delete, replace or reorder the elements. So that means the tuples are immutable. Now let's see different operations we can do on tuples. Let us start with creating a tuple. So how to create a tuple? So tuple will always start with the brackets, open brackets. Now let me just show you practically. So let me just create a new Python file. I will name it as a tuple. Okay. Now here I will create a few tuples here. Suppose let's say t1 is my variable. Let's say if I say only empty bracket, so this will create an empty tuple with no data. And if you want to add some few values to the tuple, let us say t2 and the same open braces, we can add numbers. Let's say 11, 25 or 26, something like that. So this is a tuple which contains three elements. And also we can create tuple like this. Let's say t3 and here this is open bracket. Right? This is representing the tuple. Again, inside this we can specify the list. So how we can specify the list in the bracket, square brackets. Here we can specify some elements like this. So this is also perfectly right. So here the list, the tuple contains a list of elements. This is also right notation. And we can also create a tuple like this. Let's say t4. This is a variable, right? So here we can just say tuple of ABC. So normally ABC is a string, right? So double quotation ABC is a string. Now what this tuple will do is this tuple function will convert this ABC into multiple type of elements, right? A will be treated as a separate character, B will be treated as a separate character and C will be treated as a separate character. Now this tuple function will convert ABC into multiple characters. Now let's print all these tuples one after another. Let's say print, first I will print T1 and then print T2. And then I will print T3 and finally I'll print T4. This is a T4, right? Now let's run this code and see what could be the output. So the first one is empty, so because we don't have any values in that tuple, and the second 11 25 46 and then T3 1 2 3 4 5 6 8, perfectly right. And the T4, observe this T4. So in the T4, what I have done is I have just stored the string into a tuple, and before storing the string into tuple, I have just converted that into tuple type. So it is converted into tuple, then stored in the T4 variable. Now it prints the values A, B, C like this. Okay. So this is how we need to just create a tuples and we can read the values from tuple. Now let's move on to the next one, tuples functions. So if you want to perform certain actions, we have few methods, functions provided by Python, like maximum function, minimum length, sum. So these functions can also be used with the tuples. So because these functions we already used before with the list, right? And the same functions again we can use with the tuples. So let's say minimum function will give you minimum value, and maximum function will return maximum value, and sum function will return all sum of all these values in the tuple. And length function will give you how many values present in the tuple. Now let's see this programmatically. So here I will create a tuple. It's a t1 and in the bracket, open brackets, I can just say few numbers randomly. Let's say 1, 15, 60 or 60 or 100, okay, and then 20 and something like this. So I have few values here. Now I want to find out maximum, minimum, sum and a length of these length of the values. So let's say minimum of t1 and this will return minimum value from the tuple. So we can just use a print function to print that value, and then I'll just find out the maximum value. Let's say print maximum of tuple name. We have to see, we have to give tuple name, print maximum of t1, and similarly we have to print sum of the values in the tuple, and then I will print length, how many values in the tuple. Now run this code. This will give you exactly 1 is the minimum number, maximum is 100, and sum of all the numbers are 196, and how many values we have. Totally 5 values we have, so totally 5 is written. So this is how we can just use a few functions on tuples, but we cannot edit, add, remove the values from the tuple because this is immutable. Okay, now let's move on to the next one, iterating through tuples. So we can use for loop to read the values from the tuple. So how we can do this? We have few values here, right? So we can just say for loop for I in t, t is a tuple, and every time it will read one by one values and store that into I. I'm just to print that value here. Now let's see this programmatically. So here I'm taking same tuple t1 having some values. So I will write one for loop here, right? So for, let me take a temporary variable I, okay, in t. So t1, so t1 is having all the tuples, all the values, right, colon, and here just I will print a I value. Now let's see what happens. It will give all the values 115, 60, 120, one after another. Suppose I want to print all of them in the same line, then I can just pass one more parameter and is equal to, let's say, a double quotes. Now when I run this code, it will give you all the values in the same line. So we can also write a for loop to read the values from the tuple. The next one is slicing. So slicing was there for all kinds of data type, like we have seen for list, string, dictionary, right? So here slicing is all same for tuple also, just like a string and list, we can also do the slicing here. So slicing means we can extract some values based upon the index number, starting index and ending index number. Now when I say here, let's go to programmatically. So here I have 115, 60, 100, 200, right? I want to extract a few values. Let's say t of the bracket, I'll just say 0 colon 4. So what this will return basically, so t1 is a tuple. So what this will return is basically, so 0 is a starting position. So starting position is 1. Okay, 0 representing the 1. So 4 numbers it will return from there, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So till 100, it will print till 100. Means 1 should print, 15 should print, 60, and then 100. Now let's run this code. Now it will print, it doesn't print anything because we haven't put that into print statement. Just use a print command here, right? So now run this code. Now we can see 115, 60 and 100. So this is how we can just extract the values by specifying the size, specifying the size. So let me just give you one more command. Let's say print, okay, and t1 of, first slice I don't, haven't given anything, let's say 3 now. So what this will return? So I don't specify anything at the beginning, it will be treated as a 0 only. Okay, so what should it return? So 0 means 1, from 1 to 3 characters. So 1, 2 and 3 characters, that means 1, 15 and 60 will be written. Now run this, it will give you 1, 15 and 60. And similarly I can just say print t1, okay, right? So print t1 of, I specify 0 at the positioning and the last index, I haven't specified anything. Now let's see what this will return. So this will return all the values till the end, because we haven't specified any ending index, it will repeat it till end. It will get all the values from the last value. So here from 0 it is started, right? So 1, from there 15, 16, 100, 20. So all the stuff will be written. So this is how we can just do the slicing on tuples. Now let's move on to the next one, in and not in operator. So these operators we are using for all kinds of data types like list, dictionary and strings, right? So these operators again will be there for tuple. So when I say in means, if suppose some value is present in this list, that will return true. If that value is not present in this list, that will be returned false. Now let me just show you here. Let me just remove this. Now I have few elements in the tuple. I want to verify the 100 is part of in this list or not. So how we can do this? Simply I can just say print. Okay, so I can just say what is the value we have? 100 I'm verified, right? So 100 in t1. 100 in t1. T1 is a tuple. So 100, if 100 is present in this list, it returns true. If it is not present, it returns false. So when I run this, It returns true because 100 is present. Okay, this will return set true. Fine. Now I'll just give you a different value which is not present in tuple. Let's see what this will happen. So in the second time I am giving something called 200, right? So 200 in t1. So 200 is not part of t1, so it should return false. And I say false, it returns. Okay, and not in is exactly opposite of this. So same thing, if I run, so first one is returns true, right? And the second one returns false. So same command, if I run with not in operator, it will exactly the opposite of in operator. When I say not in, the first one will return false, right? And because 100 is not in t1, we are saying, but 100 is there, right? So it returns false. Second thing, 200 is not in t1, we are saying. So 200 is not in t1, that is true. So it will return true. So completely, this is opposite of in operator. Now when I run this, true false and false true. Okay, so this is how we can just use in and not in operator with tuples. Okay, so that's all for this video. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.